As Australians cast their vote, the news filtered through: two more of our soldiers had been killed on duty in Afghanistan. Two others were wounded in the roadside bomb attack. 10 reporter Lisa Rolls is embedded with their battalion and was there when the news broke.
Soldiers here have been counting the days until they get to go home. They've been here on this patrol base since the beginning of the year and have just 6 to 8 weeks to go on their deployment, and that's what makes these deaths so much harder to cope with. It was their boss who took the call at the command post yesterday to say two of his Australian soldiers were dead and another two were wounded. The soldiers rolled out of this patrol base in Chura Valley 3 days ago. It was to be a routine convoy south, part of a mission to search and clear IEDs from the local area. But at 4 o'clock Australian time yesterday afternoon, they hit one, just 20 kilometres away.
It is tough, very tough, and it's dangerous.
35-year-old father of two, Private Grant Kirby, and 21-year-old Private Thomas Dale were killed instantly.
G'day, I'm Private Grant Kirby from 6RO in Brisbane. Just want to wish Happy Australia Day to my family back home in Brisbane, especially my two little girls, Isabella and Madeline. Hope you have a great Australia Day, and I'll see you soon.
Two other soldiers were wounded but are expected to make a full recovery. Their mates from mentoring team Charlie were back patrolling today, but for them it's a psychological and emotional struggle. It's only 6 weeks since they lost their good friend Private Nathan Buse in a similar IED strike.
The weapons and tactics of the Taliban insurgency are vicious and they are insidious.
Two more names will now be added to their memorial here. Yesterday's deaths bringing the number of Australians killed in this war so far to 20.
Their comrades remain very committed to our mission and to honouring the sacrifice of their fallen mates.
The deaths come less than a week after Trooper Jason Brown was killed and has cast a dark shadow on Election Day.
As Prime Minister, I would say to Australians, the mission is worthwhile.
The Coalition fully supports that mission. It's important that Australia sees that mission through.
In Afghanistan, Lisa Rolls, 10 News.
And 10 reporter Nikki Hayden's outside the inaugural barracks in Brisbane. Nikki, this is sadly becoming an all too familiar case for the troops there.
Yes, it certainly is, Tash. Less than 8 months ago, Privates Grant Kirby and Thomas Dale left through the gates here at Gallipoli Barracks. They were due home in as little as 6 weeks. Of the 9 soldiers killed in Afghanistan so far this year, 5 of them have been based here at Gallipoli. Their deaths have certainly shaken the very tight-knit community here at Inogra. They now face the very difficult task of farewelling 2 more of their mates, 2 more Aussie heroes.
Thanks so much, 10 reporter Nikki Hayden joining us there.